Welcome to KBTE Teacher Education Channel. From the subject School Management and Organization, today we will discuss about school library. It is also called as library. So here, books are collected and preserved in library. Therefore, the library occupies a very prominent place in the educational setup. Modern changing pattern of education demands that learning must be accelerated and broadened by the use of many devices and materials. So here, library is an essential part of school. In a dynamic approach to teaching, it supplies enriched materials in the field of study. Enriched material means what? Developed material. All good methods of education postulate the existence of well-stocked, efficiently organized library. Modern teaching classroom centered, but child-centered and library-centered. The child's learning has to be self-directed. Means that by using a library, learner is going to direct in a self manner. He has to acquire reading skills and do reading activities through the school library itself only. While curriculum and textbooks aims at providing the least common multiple of all students in a class, the library aims at bringing out the individual differences and developing special interest and aptitudes on their best advantage. So it is one of the duty of the school to provide this environment of attractive books. So then only pupil or students are going to use that library in effective manner. So here the importance of school library. First one, progressive education. The school library proves to be an instrumental in putting progressive methods of teaching like Dalton plan and project method into practice. Because by using library, student is going to get progress himself or herself. Next, second one, self-education. Library is going to play an important role in providing self-education to the all students. Because it provides self-study and self-education, it supplements class works by increasing students' vocabulary. As it is not possible for a single student to afford to purchase all the books that he needs, the school library comes to his assistance and helps him read any number of books he feels interested in. So here, if student is not able to purchase books, so that student can able to read any number of books in a library. Because in library, number of books are available for reading or for referent itself only. So that's why students are going to use that library for the purpose of collecting information by using reference material. Next, third one, broadening outlook. A school library broadens the outlook of the students by placing before them a vast store of useful information that has accumulated through the ages. When student is going to visit that library, is going to understand that library is a storehouse of knowledge. Because in library, vast knowledge is available from vast areas, then automatically that school library broadens the outlook of the students. Next one, wider interests. The students develop wider interest, means different interests, and are encouraged to write their own books when they grow up. By using a library, by reading books in the library, by collecting information, by using reference material in the library, students are going to get interest, students are going to get encouraged to write books when they grow up. Next, help in extracurricular activity. It assists the students in preparing themselves for taking part in the various co-curricular activities of the school. They get valuable information which is of great help to them in taking part in debates, contests, giving lectures and writing for the school magazine. And the next one, use of leisure. Library reading is a good leisure time hobby. It provides an opportunity for the right use of one's leisure time. It conserves the time and energy otherwise to be worked in card games, gossiping and cinemas. So that's why whatever time is available for the student, so that student can use his or her time in effective manner when library is available in the school. Next, love of books. Library develops habits of the students to develop or to derive pleasure and information from recreational and informative books. When students are going to read books in the library, they are going to get pleasure, they are going to get recreation, and they are going to get information. When they get informative books in the library, then automatically they feel pleasure in the library. And next, discipline. Library solves the problems of school discipline by providing an opportunity of the students to make the best use of leisure time. If leisure time is there, if students are having time, if they will use that time by reading books in a library, then automatically that helps to maintain discipline in the school. Next, inspiration. A good library provides inspirational books which enables the readers' lives. It satisfies their hunger of reading books and saves them from harmful effect of reading unsuitable and injurious literature. Because in library, you can't expect that there is a possibility of unsuitable and injurious literature which is going to available in the library. Whatever literature is available in the library, that literature is very useful to the students. Next, proper use of books. The library imparts training to the students in the proper use of books. Because when student will goes into the library, there are rules will be there. By following those rules and regulations only, student is going to utilize library in a proper manner. When is going to collect book, when is going to kept book in the library. So there is well organized structure is there. So that's why learner or student is going to learn how to use books in a proper manner. So here the students develop the habit of keeping books neat and tidy, because those books are library books. 100% as a student, you have to maintain those books in a neat manner, in a tidy manner. Otherwise, you are going to get fined from the library. Next, punctuality. By impressing upon the students the necessity of borrowing and returning books in time, the library imparts training in punctuality. Because in library, student is going to get book from the library. When is going to borrow book from the library, at the time of borrowing book from the library only, what will be there? Returning date of the book will be there. So on same returning day, you are going to submit, otherwise you are going to get fined. So that's why you are going to borrow the record, you are going to return that book in time. So automatically, so this activity leads to develop habit of punctuality. Next, silent reading. the library develops the habit of silent reading because reading, borrowing and returning are the watchwords of library. Because for not doing a disturbance to other students, there is need to read books in a library in a silent manner without moving lips and without using sounds. So that's why silent reading helps to maintain discipline in the library. Next, when we will discuss about library, four terms are going to play an important role. What are they? The following terms regarding the school library are worth remembering. What are they? First one, librarian. Librarian, a staff member assigned to perform professional library service activities such as ordering, cataloging, processing and circulating books and other materials, planning the use of library by teachers, pupils and others, selecting books and materials, participating in faculty planning for the use of books and materials, and guiding teachers, pupils and others in the use of library in schools or community service programs. So these all are the duties and responsibilities of librarian. Next, second one, library books. Books purchased for general use and not primarily for use in certain classes, grades, particular student groups. They include reference set and dictionaries, but not textbooks and periodicals. Next, third one, library books for students. The number of volumes of library books in the library of a school or school system divided by student unit of measure. So based on the student unit only, books are going to be divided. Next, fourth one, library classification system. Ways to label and arrange materials on library shelves so they can be easily located. In most libraries, the Dewey decimal system is practiced. So for the purpose of locating books in an easy manner, arrangement of books in library is going to play an important role. When books are arranged in library in alphabetical order, then it is easy for the librarian to identify the book where actually that book is there in the library. So these all are the four library terms. Next, objectives of the school library. First one, to facilitate the instructional program for the teacher with a wide variety of text and reference books related to various school subjects, library facilities and the instructional program. It provides reading materials to the pupil, means that students, for answering questions, for doing assignment and for solving problems. Next, second one, to teach a skillful use of books for self-education. Next, third one, to create an atmosphere conducive means what? Peaceful, to the growth of reading habits. Next, fourth one, to stimulate literary appreciation, means that when students will come to the library by reading different types of literary books, students are going to get appreciation towards literature. Next, fifth one, to demonstrate the desirability of books and libraries as companions in one's leisure. When library is there, whatever leisure time is there, to use the leisure time in a proper manner, what is going to play an important role? Library is going to play an important role. Next, sixth one, to provide fruitful social experiences, because in library, learner is going to get social experiences only. And last one, to make the library an agency for curriculum enrichment, means for curriculum development, pupil exploration, means that for gaining knowledge by the pupil, and third one, the dissemination of good literature, means that spread of good literature among society, among people of the society. So these all are the objectives of school library. Next, essentials of an ideal library, means that if library is there, what facilities should be situated in the library. Number one, separate room. The first essential, first facility for a school library to work efficiently is that it must have separate room, large enough not only for the present enrollment of the school but also for any future enrollment of the students also. Its minimum size should not be less than the size of an ordinary classroom. It should be centrally located and within easy access from any point in the school building. It should have good natural light. Artificial light should also be provided by means of semi-direct fluorescent light reaching all the dark corners of the room. The floor should be soundproof. A matting of soothing color should be spread out. Next, second one, storage room. The library should be a storage room which may store books that need binding and other essential audiovisual materials. Next, third one, workroom. There should be also be a workroom consisting of big table for purpose of mending books, mounting pictures and also preparing books for the shelves. And fourth one, adequate furniture. The library should have adequate reading tables and chairs. The chairs should be light but strong. The library should have magazine stand or a rack or a desk for the librarian, cord catalytic case, a clock and a bulletin board. So the almirahs should be arranged all round the walls. The shelves should be preferably be open and not very high. And next, fifth one, display boards. The library display board should have attractive books, jackets and pictures of real educational value to the students and teachers. There should be an interesting display of new books on the new arrival display rack. Next, show window. There should also be a show window in which may be displayed some forgotten books and books by eminent authors. Ante famous authors ki sambandhinchinatvanti books gaani lekapothe konni marchipoyinatvanti books annitni kuda dentlo pettalsi untundi, show windows lo pettalsi untundi. Next, proper organization. The resources of the library should be classified, cataloged and filled. Whatever books are going to be available in the library, those books are going to be classified, means that into different pots, and cataloged, means that arranged in a proper order and filled. The scheme of organization should be simple enough to be understood easily. It will help in increasing efficiency of service to pupils and teachers. And next, eighth one, adequate books. The library must possess adequate books appropriate to age, taste and standard of the children in the school. The books chosen should deal with human actions and with motives which can easily be understood. The story books should dominate in the junior classes. In the senior classes, books of a more serious mature such as tales of travel and exploration, biographies and playlists may also be included. History and biographies are not only for information but also transport you to other times and lives. Fairy tales, legends and myths, stories of animals as well as of incidents in the lives of great men and women, adventures and experiences of boys and girls, all these furnish suitable material. And next, ninth one, practical books. There should be plenty of practical books dealing with subjects pertaining to the environment of the pupil, the everyday world around him, such as plants, animals, steam engine, railways, ship, motor, the aeroplane, the radio, cinematography, the television, architecture, fine arts, games, and scouting, etc. So the all types of books should be available in the library. Next, periodicals and magazines. The library should subscribe to a number of periodicals and magazines. Newspapers from indispensable part of any library of all languages, pamphlets and clippings have been called the shortcuts for busy. So these all are invaluable reference aids. Next, a code of rules. Code of rules to regulate the use of library is to be evolved for efficient service, because organization, management and administration of the library is always depends upon a code of rule itself only. The rule should be clear and simple. There should be place the fewest people possible obstacles in the way of the use of the library. The librarian must compile and maintain self-register, association record, catalog and issue statistics. He must decide upon circulation methods and other routines. He must arrange for the withdrawal, binding, replacement of the damaged books. And next one, decorations. The library should be decorated with beautiful and meaningful pictures on all possible topics, illustrating and supplementing classwork. One or two distinct works of art, a few vases for flowers, colored maps and bright posters, preferably made by the pupils themselves, add lot of color and cheer to the library and make it a pleasant place. And last one, proper atmosphere. The atmosphere in the library should breathe a sense of a general seeking of knowledge and a love of the true, good and beautiful. It should provide relief from the daily routine of the timetable program and a classroom discipline. It should provide inspiration when needed. It should be the intellectual hub of the school where readers come to refresh and recreate themselves. So these all are the facilities or essentials of an ideal library. So this is about library. Thank you.